college fashion. So today, the look that I have for you guys is for summer outdoor activities, such as barbecues, you know, those activities that lead from the day into the night, where you don't want to go home and do a makeup or wardrobe change. You kind of just want to look the same from day to night. This is perfect for those kind of occasions. I wouldn't necessarily wear this like a pool party, just in case you get into the water, get water splashed on your face, you don't want to get makeup all over the place. But for those 4th of July barbecues, you know, things like that where you're kind of outdoors, but you usually stay there until the evening, this is the perfect look for that. Alright, so I took a deep smoky eye and kind of just angled out the eyeshadow so that you kind of have that cat effect with your shadow rather than your eyeliner, and just kept your eyeliner really light and kind of smoky so it's not perfect or precise or anything. And then for your cheeks, I used a lot of cream products so that you don't look too powdery in the sunlight. And also for the lips, I just kind of kept it really simple so that you don't have to do a bunch of touch-ups throughout the day. So if you guys want to see how to get this look, then just keep on watching. Okay, so the first thing that I'm going to do is take a metallic base, and this is Indian Wood by MAC, and it's just a metallic bronze eyeshadow base, and I'm going to apply this all over my lid, and I'm also going to apply it right under my lower lash line as well, and this is just going to make the colors kind of stand out a little bit more and give them kind of like a sheen in the sunlight, because I am going to be using a lot of matte shadows. Alright, so then the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to create the cat eye shape for our eyeshadow. As you can see on this eye, I created a cat eye shape with the eyeshadow, not the eyeliner. So how we're gonna do that is we're gonna take a dark brown eyeshadow, and I'm using this one from NARS. It's called Galapagos. This one does have a couple of gold flecks in it, but you can use any dark chocolate brown that you have. I'm going to take a short shader brush, and then I'm just gonna use a piece of cardboard that I had lying around my house. And I'm going to lay this flat at kind of an angle on my eye, however you want the cat angle to look. If you want it to be like this, you know, you hold it this way. If you want it to be straight out, you hold it that way. I'm just going to have it like this because I want it to be kind of up, kind of down, you know, as if I'm doing my eyeliner. And then what you're going to do is take the brush and kind of brush up against the cardboard so that it gives a nice defined line, as you can see. And then I just kind of bring it downwards. You don't want it to be too defined. But the only reason I use the cardboard there is kind of like a guide, you know, for if you don't normally do a look like this, you would want some sort of a guide. And then I'm just going to take the shader brush and kind of begin to drag the eyeshadow in off that. So you have at this point you're going to have a nice, you know, defined line. And then just begin filling in the center. I'm going to go into a different eyeshadow brush. This is a little bit bigger to take the brown eyeshadow and bring it in a little further onto my lid. You also want to be sure to drag the eyeshadow to the bottom of your lower lash line. Alright, next thing that we're going to do is take an eyeshadow that is similar to your skin color. My favorite one to use is Suspect. This is from the Naked 2 palette. And I'm just going to flip over that eyeshadow brush I was using earlier. And you want to apply this to the remainder of your lid and begin blending it into the darker color. Alright, then what you want to do is take the darker eyeshadow that I was using earlier from NARS and take a blending brush and begin blending around the edges just to kind of make it so they're not as harsh. Because since you use the piece of cardboard, you're going to have some really harsh edges. And just begin blending until you get it to a nice gradual state. And then I'm going to take an angled blending brush and I'm going to go into Foxy, which is just a creamy highlight color that I'm going to use for my brow bone and also my inner corner. So I'm just going to take that brush and begin on my inner corner, and this is just going to be brightening up the whole brow area and helping blend the colors. You're just going to be going around the edges just so like you can kind of blend the colors in there a bit. And then I'm going to take that blending brush. I'm not going to add any more product to it, but I'm just going to use this to kind of revamp the dark color. All right, once you have it nice and blended, then you want to begin to add your eyeliner. And I'm going to use a black coal eyeliner, and this is Smolder by MAC, and I'm going to line my waterline with this. And I'm also going to line my lashes with this. And then I'm going to take a matte black eyeshadow. This is also from the Naked 2 palette. This is just a matte black. It's called Blackout. And I'm going to take that short smudger brush that I was using earlier. And I'm going to just go along my lashes with this to make sure there's no, you know, like blanks or anything. And to soften the line, because we want this whole look to be kind of smoldering and really soft. Alright, now obviously we're going to leave the false lashes at home for any type of outdoor activities. So I'm just going to apply a generous amount of mascara, because you do want your lashes to pop, especially on top of a smoky eye. So I'm going to be using a lengthening mascara. My favorite one to use, that you guys probably already know by now if you've watched, you know, a bunch of my videos, is the CoverGirl Lash Blast Mascara. It gives you so much volume, it makes your lashes look really thick. And also apply this to my lower lashes as well. All right, now that we've finished the eyes, I'm gonna go ahead and apply my foundation like I normally would, and then show you what I'm gonna do for my cheeks and my lips. So just keep on watching. Okay, so for my face, what I'm gonna do for a highlighter is, normally I like to use like a golden highlighter, but today I'm gonna use this one because if you're gonna be going to a barbecue or any type of outdoor activity, you don't want to have like glitter on your face, like straight up glitter, because it doesn't, like, because in the sun it's going to look weird because it's glitter. So what I like to do is take an actual highlighter, and I'm using this one from Victoria's Secret. This is called Striking. It's just like a highlighter stick. I'm going to be applying it with a brush, and it just gives you kind of like a dewy look without any glitter or any shimmers, but it still gives you like that highlighted effect. And then for my cheeks, I'm going to use this blush from MAC called Poise. It's like a nice pink color. It's not over the top or anything like that, but I do like that it's a cream blush because I feel like it'll stay on a little bit better, you know, with sweating and all that. It kind of will set into your skin. And it won't look as powdery in the sunlight. So I kind of feel like you don't want to use that many powder products when you're going to be in the sun because it's going to look powdery. You know, when people look at you, when the sunlight hits you, you don't want to look super powdery or anything. So just apply that. Then for the lips, I want to keep it simple, and I kind of want it to look a little more natural, just like you kind of have on a lip gloss. So I'm going to take this pink Infallible, L'Oreal Infallible lip pencil. This is in the color Mauve, and I'm just going to line my lips with it and fill my lips in with this as well. And then right on top of that, I'm going to use this Shine Sensationals Lip Gloss in Watermelon Punch. And this is by Maybelline. And this is just to give my lips some shine. Alright, so this is the completed look. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And if you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them down below. And I will get back to you guys as soon as I can. Bye!